main topic of our show. Okay? It's something down your alley. This caught my eye just like by fluke. I was just going through one morning, I came from work, and I'm like, you know what? I think Scotty might be interested in talking about this. What am I talking about, Scotty? The X-Men. It's been such a big issue of how is Kevin Feige going to be bringing X-Men back into the MCU?
It's funny because Kevin Feige, when he was at D23. Comic-Con was introducing Blade and all that.
Okay.
He didn't say X-Men. He said mutants. So maybe they're not even going to call it X-Men.
Like New Mutants? Like how the comic books was original? It was New Mutants and then
maybe
got into
maybe just I'm interpreting it wrong maybe. Okay. I don't know. He didn't say X-Men. He said mutants.
Yeah, it wasn't his plan originally, Scott. He said 3 or 5 years down the road kind of thing.
Yeah.
Because people have been saying that maybe they'll show up or be introduced in the externals.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think it's going to happen? Or you think it's too soon? Or yeah, like maybe like a post-credit thing maybe?
A post-credit scene
might see something a little odd because they are gods or whatever the hell they are. I don't even know.
A post-credit scene, a perfect way to end it would be the Eternals looking at some holographic thingy-majiggy.
Some image of something popping up.
And maybe in the 50 years and 100,000 years, I don't know how far
back the hell it is, yeah.
There's going to be an X-gene, something called an X-gene that will change humanity. Mm-hmm. And then there's slowly you're introducing the X-gene and the X-Men.
Creep them in.
Exactly.
For me, Scott, the reason why I wanted to bring this topic is because I know if you guys read the comic books, I haven't read an X-Men book in, my God, 10 years, a decade. When was the last time you read one, Scott?
Longer than that, maybe.
Since you were born.
I don't know. I think I was in grade 5 last time I read one.
Wow, that's quite a while back, eh? But anyways, I guess Jonathan Hickman, or whatever his name is, his run on the X-Men titles is coming to an end. And apparently, with what's going down, the status quo of the X-Men are changing. Myra McTaggart, or whatever, Myra X, I don't even know. I'm just reading whatever I kind of glimpse across, guys, mm-hmm. is that she's apparently been a mutant all this time and she can reincarnate and she's seen what has happened to Charles and the X-Men in the future and it doesn't look good no matter which way. So she actually comes back and convinces Xavier that, hey, you got to change your ways and, you know, you being, you know, in coexistence with humans ain't going to work for you. It doesn't look good. So apparently from what I read that you have Xavier now started his own country or state, I don't even know, called Krakoa, whatever. I don't even know why he chose that name, Scott, right? But apparently he's like recruiting all mutants to live in this one area, like Magneto, Apocalypse and stuff.
So basically they're taking stuff from Wonder Woman, Themyscira, the Amazons live all in one secret
Scotty,
island.
Magneto did it with Genosha or whatever he did when he had the Savage Land or whatever the hell,
exactly.
When all the mutants were together.
And you know what? And that's the perfect way to...
That's how you survive, Scotty. That, realistically, you always thought... I know Xavier wanted a peaceful coexistence between normal people and mutants. It never happened, right?
And that can be a perfect way to introduce the X-Men in the MCU. It's like, where have they been all this time?
An undiscovered country called Krakoa, whatever, and you introduce them that
exactly.
way. And you have all the mutants together, good and bad, mm-hmm. and then they'll be followed. Obviously, you're going to pick sides, and you get your Xavier and Magneto split up.
Exactly.
And you're starting from scratch, right, Scott?
Exactly. So they're in their own island, your country, whatever.
Minding their own business.
They don't know. They know what's going on with the Avengers and all that.
Exactly.
But they're just stepping away, like Wakanda.
Yep.
They stayed away from all the mess. Mm-hmm.
Isolation.
Exactly. So that's perfect.
And then you got the new titles coming out, new material that they can pull and grab. Kevin Feige can now pick and choose anything.
Oh,
or it's like a clean slate.
Yeah.
Just like how the X-Men films with Fox ended like badly.
Yeah.
You could just wipe the slate clean. You have the new books in the comics and you can take now and you can pretty much dictate how you want the mutants to be introduced, you know?
Exactly.
But overall, I'm happy. Well, we see it in the externals, just maybe in a post-credit that means
yeah,
Scotty
they'll just mention,
agreed.
They'll just mention the X-Gene and then you can slowly bring them in afterwards.
And then you've got Scarlet Witch, maybe you say that. Maybe they're not mystical powers, maybe they're more...
They're mutant powers.
Exactly.
Just the Mind Stone just unlocked it.
There you go. And then you can introduce Magneto's connection if they're going to do that, go that way. Quicksilver maybe be back again, who knows? You know, it's the MCU, it's the fake death universe.
I know.
They never stay dead. They come back somehow, right, Scott?
Well, Quicksilver is the only hero that's been dead all this time.
And for now, Black Widow and who's the other one who died? And
Iron Man
for now. But, you know, from 4, 3, 5 years down the road when they establish the new characters, they're coming back. Chris Evans will be back and all that.
Yeah.
We still have Thor. Thank God for Thor. Right, Scotty?
We do.
Okay, Scotty, I think...